Hi viewers, welcome to Shravs Cookbook. Today I'm going to show the recipe of Veg Haleem. Haleem is a popular recipe from Hyderabad. During the month of Ramzan, this recipe is prepared and you can see every street of Hyderabad, there will be a mandi where they cook mutton and chicken haleems. Veg Haleem is rarely cooked, but today I'm going to show the recipe of how to make Veg Haleem at home. This haleem is a healthy recipe as lot of nutritional ingredients go into its making. So let us check the ingredients needed. Fried onions. I have taken two onions and I have fried them till they get caramelized. Mint leaves, half cup. Coriander leaves, half cup. Dried rose petals for garnishing. Half lemon juice will go into its making and two lemon wedges for garnishing. Ghee, 3 tablespoons. Milk, half cup. Curd, 2 teaspoons. Green chilies, 3 vertically slit. Ginger garlic paste, 1/2 teaspoon. Dalia, that is broken wheat, 1/2 cup. This is the key ingredient in making this haleem. Sesame seeds, 1 teaspoon, almonds, 5, carrots, 1/2 cup. Here I have taken only carrots, but if you want you can take beans and green peas also. These are soya chunks. I have boiled them, squeezed the water and I have finely chopped them. Instead of this, if you have the soya granules, then directly you can boil them and use them. Since I don't have soya granules, I have used soya chunks. I have boiled them, squeezed them and chopped into fine pieces. Along with dalia, this soya is a key ingredient in making this haleem. This soya pieces give the feel of chicken or mutton pieces in your veg haleem, though they are not. Next, oats. 2 teaspoons, moong dal 1 teaspoon, chana dal 1 teaspoon, urad dal 1 teaspoon, tuwar dal 1 teaspoon, water 1.5 to 2 cups, it depends upon the requirement. Next, the spices are star anise 1, green cardamoms 2, cloves 4, shah jeera 1/2 teaspoon, peppercorns 1/2 teaspoon, cinnamon powder 1 teaspoon. I have cinnamon powder, so I have used this. If you have cinnamon stick, then take 1 inch piece. Turmeric powder 1/4 teaspoon, salt to taste. Now as we have checked all the ingredients needed to prepare this veg haleem recipe, let us proceed to make the veg haleem at home. First of all, we need to dry roast all the whole garam masalas. I'm adding cloves, cardamom pods, star anise, shah jeera, peppercorns. Since cinnamon powder is already, I'm using powder, I'm not dry roasting it because it will get burnt. I'm dry roasting, I didn't add any oil. Now in this, I'm adding all the dals and oats, that is chana dal, urad dal, moong dal, tuwar dal and the oats. Now I'm adding sesame seeds and almonds also to dry roast. Let us saute this for a minute. Now I'm adding dalia. The dals and all the other ingredients have been nicely roasted. Have switched off the flame. Now I'm adding cinnamon powder. 1/2 of the fried onions. I'm adding 1/2 now and remaining 1/2 we'll keep it for garnishing. Now let us grind this to a fine powder.
I have grinded all the roasted, dry roasted ingredients to a fine powder. Now let us keep this aside.
Now let us heat a pressure pan. I'm adding ghee in this.
Once the ghee has become hot, now we'll add green chilies and ginger garlic paste. Once the green chilies and ginger garlic paste have been sauteed, now we'll add carrots. If you're adding green peas and baked French beans, then you can add them at this stage. Let us toss this for a minute. I've sauteed the carrots for a minute. Now I'm adding soya chunks. If you have soya granules and boiled soya granules, then you can add this at this stage. Our soya chunks and carrots have been fried nicely. Now in this I'm adding turmeric powder. Mint leaves. Have kept some for garnishing. Coriander leaves. I have kept some for garnishing as well. Let us toss this for a minute. Pudina and coriander leaves have been nicely fried. Now I'm adding curd. This nicely. Now I'm adding our ground masala powders, all the powders. Let us mix this once nicely. Now I'm adding 2 cups of water in this. One more cup of water, 2 cups in whole. Now let us mix this nicely. Mix this nicely without any lumps. Now let us cover this and cook for 2 whistles. Have pressure cooked this for 2 whistles. And after 2 whistles, I have waited till the pressure is completely released. I have opened the lid. Our vegetables and all these are properly cooked. Now, in order to give the gooey and soft consistency, creamy consistency, we need to add some more water. I am adding 1 cup of water now. Also, salt for seasoning. Let us mix this nicely. Now, I am adding milk in this. Let us mix this nicely. Now, using a potato masher, I'll mash this to get a soft and creamy consistency. Using a potato masher, I'm mashing this. If any vegetables or so, that is our carrot or something, is not cooked, then it will get mashed. However, for 2 whistles, all the vegetables, carrot, etc. will be cooked. I have mashed this haleem for about 5 minutes now. It has become to a soft and creamy consistency. Now, I'll squeeze some lime, lemon juice. Now we'll dish it out onto a serving plate. Our haleem is ready. I'm adding a spoonful of ghee and let us dish it out. Our veg haleem has been cooked properly. Now I have dished it out onto a serving bowl. I have garnished it with fried onions, some fried cashews,
dried rose petals, coriander and mint leaves. If you want to add, you can add a spoonful of haleem as well. Some lemon pieces too for garnishing. This haleem will be very yummy and it's a very healthy recipe. Do try this recipe. If you like my recipe, then do click the like button. Please post your valuable comments. And also do subscribe to my channel Shravs Cookbook for more such yummy recipes. Thanks for watching Shravs Cookbook. Thank you.